This is Martha. Today is my day 7 after I underwent gastric bypass surgery because of my weight. It has been tough, very tough. Because after surgery, the second day, yeah, I developed some breathing complications, and I had to be taken back to the ICU for watch because the doctor thought I had pulmonary thrombosis. So a lot of tests was done. I was on oxygen 24/7. I thought I was going to die. It was so bad because I'm in a foreign country, and I was thinking about my child, my husband and my family, and I was so scared. I've never been scared like I've been this round, and I was like, Martha, did I bring myself to come and die? But I thank my people because they really prayed hard. Because you know, as I underwent this surgery, I never saw one person that I know who went to this surgery and I could ask for their opinions or anything. I was just relying on Facebook and reading materials, and also my weight was way more. But I just want to thank God because I pulled through. I only had some blood clots in my lungs. Thank God it was detected early and it was taken care of. So it has been very tough, very tough. But I told some of my friends whom I know they're struggling with weight, and I agreed with them. I told them, let me go there and then use me as a souvenir, and I will tell you how it is. So I'm still in the process of recovering. I was shaken and scared. Sometimes even I don't know whether I should tell them to go with it or not. But look at bahati mbaya. You know, like you can go even to give birth and you develop some complication. It doesn't mean that everybody who goes there develops those complications. A lot of people are coming for surgery. And, like when I was there, a lot. And people were coming out, they didn't have any problem. But you see me, I developed breathing difficulties. But the doctors are very much on alert. They ask, why is she not breathing well? A lot of tests were conducted. And that's when they knew where the problem was. So for me to be scared, it was normal. Because it's something that, apart from talking to my doctor and knowing the procedure that I was going through, it's not something that I could even, I thought it was the surgery, 3 incision, poop, ni recover, ni tembe, ni sahau. But I thank God so much. God has been very faithful. My family has been very patient with me. My husband, my daughter, my mother, my pastor, a lot of people in Kitale prayed for me. And I thank God so much. So today is my day 7. I'm actually out of the hospital. I'm recovering in the room. I'm only having some problem with it. Let me show you. Crazy. So, see? I'm having, like, I don't know how many incisions. Sorry. I'm having like 5 incisions, but I know these ones are going to be removed on Monday. And I'm embracing the progress. So I'm now good. I'm now very good. I'm done with the liquid diet because today is my last week. So starting from tomorrow, I start taking a little bit heavy diet, some skimmed milk, and blah 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 blah. But now I'm good. I thank God. The only problem I'm having is sleeping, because in the hospital, the you know, the bed could turn it the way you want. So because I had difficulty in breathing, so it was like curved, like standing, you know. So it's like I developed some back problem, but today the back pain went. But now I can't sleep, you know, like I'm teaching myself to sleep again. But I'm good, thank God. So as I went to the surgery, imagine I went with 146.5 kilos. I had gained the kilos a lot. But by the time I'll post the progress, and if anybody would feel like this is the route they would want to go through, I'm also willing to help and show them as time goes by. So I'm so happy, and I'll keep you posted with my progress. I'll show you everything. So I'm here for the next couple of days before I travel back to Kenya. So I'll let you know. Thank you. Have a blast evening.